Many of DC's best comics rely on trickery to have that little extra something. After all, everyone likes to be surprised, and everyone hates having the same overused storylines hashed out time and time again. So why not mix things up with a little good old-fashioned plot twist? Or a new school plot twist, because many of these tricks and surprises genuinely feel like they've never been done before. Most of the best applications of these are in comic mysteries, because all the best share the fact that they have an ocean's worth of red herrings in them. That said, plenty of regular comics also trick you a fair few times, as the ever-changing timelines and backstories of DC and its characters often leads to you getting pranked by the proverbial prank patrol. I'm Zoe from What Culture, and I thought long and hard about trying to trick you guys in the intro in some way, but the real twist here is that there is no twist. Only 10 times DC Comics tricked you. Number 10, The Identity of Holiday. Perhaps the most famous of DC's clever twist endings is that of the ending of The Long Halloween, and deservedly so, as it gets its rep because it's simply a fantastic story. The Long Halloween is largely a mystery story, centered around a mysterious serial killer named Holiday. Halfway through the story, it appears as though the mystery has been solved, when Holiday is revealed to be Alberto Falcone, who has been systematically killing people off on holidays in order to spite his father for never letting him join the mafia activities of the Falcone family. At the very end of the last issue, however, things suddenly take a drastic change. Gilda Dent, Two-Face's partner, is revealed to have been responsible for the majority of the Holiday murders, in an attempt to get vengeance for her supervillain paramour. Hilariously, Batman doesn't believe Two-Face when he tells him this, as he thinks Harvey is simply too obsessed with the number two to tell him the truth. Number 9, Bane kills the Bat-Boys. If there's one thing that can be comfortably said about the Batman Rebirth series, it's that it pulls no punches in terms of loading every single issue with tricks and turns. One of the best of these is in Batman 16, which ends with what appears to be Robin, Nightwing, and the Red Hood all hung up in the Batcave as a taunt from Bane. The trick in this scene is twofold. On one hand, there will have been plenty of fans who thought this equaled the deaths of the Bat-Boys, albeit a likely temporary death. On the other, there was also likely a ton of people who expected these bodies to be that of decoys, or otherwise anyone but Batman's actual sidekicks. But both of these would be proven wrong in the next issue, which would reveal that the people strung up were in fact the various Robins, but that they hadn't been killed, but rather severely injured, with Batman keeping them in stasis until he could hunt Bane down himself. Number 8, Power Girl becomes an Atlantean. Power Girl has long been a character that DC aren't really sure what to do with, and her brief stint as an Atlantean only reinforces this. Wanting to add a little extra something to the character, Kara's Kryptonian origins were rewritten to be an illusion, as her real roots were supposedly that of a descendant of Arian, a former lord of Atlantis. While this wasn't a terrible idea, those who went on to write Power Girl shied away from the idea, to the point that it became clear that this fishy background wasn't going to be explored any further. It made for an interesting interlude, at least, even if it was only an incredibly temporary interlude. Number 7, Rick Grayson. When Nightwing was shot in the head in Batman 55, fans flew into speculation. Was the Dark Knight's first ever sidekick dead for real? Would he be subjected to the Lazarus Pits and driven insane, like his Bat brother Jason Todd? As is often the case, what actually happened was much, much weirder. Instead of being dead, because you know he was shot in the head, Dick Grayson developed intense amnesia and would become Rick Grayson. This was weird not only because it seemed like DC had made these changes after becoming uncomfortable with the name Dick, but also because Rick became everything he formerly was not. Caring and funny character became a devil-may-care bad boy who rejected all attempts at being helped by his former friends. This would prove especially infuriating because Rick still wanted to recover his past. He just didn't want anyone helping him to recall it, apparently. While Nightwing's amnesia plot appears to be closing up with him regaining his memory in issue 68, the frustrating aspects of this storyline almost make you wish he'd just died and then been brought back in the first place. Number 6, The Real Lobo. Lovers of the gruff mercenary Lobo were collectively horrified when the New 52 reboot revealed that the wise-talking Cezanian had received a revamp, and now had a decidedly sleeker design and a totally different personality, which saw him be dubbed Twilight Lobo after his resemblance to the vampires from the Twilight series. More frustrating yet, the original Lobo still existed in this universe, only as a supposed fake version of Lobo who was decapitated in the first issue of the New 52 series. After discovering that people sort of despised the new version of their anti-hero, DC got to work and devised a plan to redeem their boy. In said plan, the new Lobo would instead be uncovered to be the faker, and the real Lobo would be reintroduced after the rebirth event, meaning that everyone who believed the new Lobo would stay had been well and truly punked. It currently appears that the newer Lobo was the one who was a doppelganger all along. That's the retrospective cover-up that's been used, and thus what we should believe for now. Number 5, Murray's secret job. While it is technically a retcon, one of the coolest things about the Brightest Day series is that it shows us everything we knew about Murray before was in fact a trick. As in the comic, we learn that the wife of Aquaman and Queen of Atlantis was in fact supposed to kill him when they first met, as she was at the time an ex-Bell assassin. Despite being sent specifically to murder Aquaman, she refused to do so upon meeting him, which would result in the two growing closer and eventually getting married. Wildly, Aquaman doesn't seem to mind this revelation, despite the fact it means that she's been concealing a pretty important fact from him for all these years. Number 4, the identity of Hush. Much of the mystery of Hush is likely known to Bat fans now, especially anyone who played through the side missions in Arkham City. But at the time, it was one of the most exciting mysteries in DC. This was only made more solid by just how many red herrings the plot had. Hush appeared to be everyone from Clayface to former sidekick Jason Todd, meaning the mystery of the true identity of Hush increased over time, instead of becoming increasingly more obvious. Hush would eventually be revealed to be none other than Bruce's former best friend, Thomas Elliot, a famous surgeon who would later have his face transformed into Wayne's, just to make things a little more complicated. While fans tend to either love it or hate it, there's one thing for sure. Few other stories pull the wool over our eyes quite so many times. Number 3, Yo-Yo Lives. On a first read of The Suicide Squad, it seems as though the supervillain Yo-Yo is just one of many poor unfortunates to die while working for Amanda Waller, as he's eaten by King Shark in the third issue, and for all intents and purposes, seems to die there. Until 6 issues later, when it's uncovered that Yo-Yo was actually subjected to a much worse fate, as he's recovered from King Shark's maw alive. This means that through all the team's adventures in this time, Yo-Yo was with them, just trapped in the stomach of an angry fishman. While this would lead to an interesting reveal that the character was totally indestructible, he would still be retconned out of existence. And right as he got interesting, too. Number 2, the fake Joker. When the Joker showed up in the 2016 Harley Quinn comic, nobody thought anything about it. Even when he told Harley he'd decided to change and be better to her, it didn't seem too unbelievable. After all, he was either lying just to get her back, or a nicer imagining of the Joker than we usually see. As it turns out, neither of these were the actual explanation for the Crown Prince of Crime's sudden romantic turn. Instead, it turns out that this isn't actually the Joker, but rather a man named Edwin who had gotten surgery to look exactly like the Jester himself. Since he looked exactly like the Joker, and managed to act and sound exactly like him, it seemed as though there was no way Harley would ever uncover this secret. Only, there was one very specific part of Edwin's anatomy that he didn't get changed with surgery. And it's also a part that Harley is familiar enough with that she immediately recognizes it isn't right. It's a unique way to uncover a secret, that's for sure. Number 1, the Hero Killer. Heroes in Crisis set up what was, like it or hate it, an incredibly interesting premise for a comic, as it was based around a rehabilitation center for superheroes. Said center would then have the heroes in it slaughtered, leading to a murder mystery where those left tried to work out what happened and who was responsible. And much like any good whodunit tale, the story purposefully tricks you into suspecting everyone but the true culprit. With Harley Quinn beginning the series by needlessly stabbing Booster Gold, it seems obvious that she's the culprit, right up until she's proven completely innocent. Instead, the hero killer turns out to be none other than Wally West, who you'd never suspect because he's seen dead in the first issue. As it turns out, the Flash travels back in time, leaves a dead version of himself by the crime scene, and then attempts to fix the disaster that he accidentally caused by losing control of his powers. It's annoying in the sense that it's a mystery that'd be impossible to solve beforehand, but it's a good twist nonetheless. And those were our twists. Any other ones you can think of? Let us know down in the comments below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'm Zoe from What Culture, and after all these twists and turns, I'm too bamboozled to give you any funny quips. So instead, I'll just hope you've had a good day, and maybe a nicer tomorrow.
Hello, YouTube! We're turning things up to 11 with the launch of What Culture Music.
It's our brand new channel featuring all those lists you just can't get enough of, including creepy hidden messages in your favorite pop songs.
As well as radio-friendly songs that detail literal murder. That's as well as Chatty Faces, where we get personal with you on our sordid musical tastes, in-depth discussion podcasts, and we're even doing quality fun stuff like tournaments and quizzes too.
There's gonna be something for everybody, so come on over and make some sweet, sweet music with us.
Or just watch the videos, that works too.
Like, share, and subscribe at the link below, and we will see you there.
Bye.